students, welcome to our session today. I'm your instructor, CPA Aringo Frederick. So today I want us to talk about taxation. And the moment you're talking about taxation, what should ring at the back of your mind is that, remember last year, 2020, a lot changed in taxation. There were a lot of amendments that were done. So remember, and for those students who will be doing the examinations this year, this is 2021, you should be very updated. So the advice that I can give you guys is that make sure that even if you're using the notes for last semester, make sure that they are updated. At least there are some specific areas that you should update. So I wouldn't advise, by the way, you guys to use the notes for last semester. Because whatever that you taught last semester in tax, there are a lot of things that has changed. And remember, like say for example, when you're talking of capital allowance, this is very common in each and every question in tax. And capital allowance has changed. When you're talking of, probably talk of course, like that one you'll be given in your exams, talk of employment income, the graduated scale rate. That one has changed. Talk about withholding taxes. There are some of the withholding taxes that have been amended. So you'll find that this is an year that is going to be very tricky, more so for those students who are doing tax. And the beauty part of it is that at MDARASA, at this point, we are going to give you the updated notes. We are going to teach you using the updated rates. So if you have not joined MDARASA, join MDARASA as soon as possible. More so when it comes to tax, I really wish and advise you guys to be updated whenever you're handling tax. Those are the students who are doing Section 2, Public Finance and Taxation, and those who are doing Section 6, Public Finance and Taxation. So today's class, I want us to handle one of the items which changed, and I want you to see the effect. And today's class, we'll be talking of capital allowances. Today's class, we'll be talking of capital allowances. I want us to talk about capital allowances. Remember, this is one of the main elements that has really changed. The rates that were used previously are not the same rates that we're going to use in our current period. Because for you guys who will be doing exams in April, you are going to be tested with regard to what? With regard to the financial year 2020. So, looking at capital allowance ideally, I know in our previous video we did capital allowance, but recall we used previous rates. So in today's class, I want us to talk about the new rates that we will be tested during this year. And I repeat again, kindly, kama uliomba mtu kitabu ya last semester and tax, tafadhali wachana nayo. Tafuta yule ako class saizi. Even if, for example, maybe you don't have enough resources to join the classes, tafuta mtu ako class, omba yeye updated notes. Because if you don't do that, you're going to mess big up when it comes to tax. When it comes to tax because of the changes, okay? So when you're talking of capital allowances, my good students, so should come at the back of your mind. In simple terms, you normally say that capital allowance is a deduction an investor is allowed to make on capital expenditure incurred on industrial buildings, machines, and any other assets used for business. So in simple terms, you are saying that capital allowance is a deduction. These are a deduction. An investor is allowed to make on capital expenditure incurred on industrial buildings, incurred on industrial buildings, talk of machines, and any other asset and any other asset, and any other asset, and any other asset used for business purposes. Used for business purposes. Used for business purposes. Used for business purposes. So this is a simple definition of what capital allowance is. Then the moment I'm able to understand what capital allowance is, it is very ideal for us to go deep and look at what will be the impact of capital allowance in our business. So probably another point which is also very key that you can also add, you cannot say that you'll find that talk of qualifying cost, another important element under capital allowance, we normally term it as what? Qualifying cost. Let me have it in full. This is known as what? Qualifying cost. A good student will ask Mwalimu, what is qualifying cost? So basically, whenever we're talking of qualifying cost, ideally, this is a cost that is going to be subjected for what? For capital allowance. So we normally say that qualifying cost is a cost that is subjected for capital allowance. Qualifying cost is a cost that is subjected for capital allowance. That is a very key element that you'll find. It will affect us all through when we'll be dealing with what? When we'll be dealing with capital allowances. Now, the moment I'm able to know that one, let us go straight and look at types of capital allowance quickly. Types of capital allowances. I want us to go through these types of capital allowances very quickly. Number one type of capital allowance that you must always have at the back of our mind is what? Investment deduction. Investment deductions. Commonly known as what? ID. Number two, we normally talk of what? Industrial building deductions. Commonly known as what? IBD. Or we normally term it as what? Mr. Debt. We normally term it as Mr. Debt. Talk of number three, we normally talk of wear and tear allowances. Commonly known as what? WTA. And also the beauty part of this, we'll also be looking at what? Mining allowances. We can also talk of what? You can also talk of number five key element, farm work deductions. Pia wakulima wako allowed. Talk of number six, we'll be talking of about shipping investment deductions. These are very key elements that you must always be having at the back of our mind. So these are some of the major types of capital allowances. So remember all these, they are affected with the new rates. So for us to understand the concept clearly, what we'll be doing, we'll be looking at the previous rates, we compare them with the new rates. So to do this, this is what you're going to do, my good students. We start with the first one, investment deduction, commonly known as what? ID. We start with the first one, number one, or A, let us talk of investment deductions, commonly known as ID. A very key element that you must always be having at the back of our mind. And if you've not downloaded Mdarasa app, this app is a revolutionary app, more so for those students who are doing accounts. Go to Play Store, download Mdarasa app for you to get clear, updated notes. We also have video tutorials like this on the one that you're seeing, probably if it's in YouTube, if you're seeing it probably on Facebook, if you're seeing it probably on Instagram, whichever social media that you are viewing this video. We have more of these videos in our phone application. And the beauty part of it is that we normally tend to update these videos with the current amendments. Let's say, like, for example, like this for tax. I know a lot of probably even some colleges, they haven't yet updated such, but for us, we've updated this to make sure that you get the right and required element that you need, So looking at investment deduction, my good students, looking at investment deductions, what is investment deduction? That should be a very, so we normally say that investment deduction is a capital deduction on cost of the building. We are saying that investment deduction is a capital deduction given on cost of buildings and machineries which are used for manufacture. And mark that word very correctly. We are saying that is a capital deduction given on cost of buildings and machineries, cost of buildings and machineries used in manufacture. Talk of what? On cost of a ship and on cost of hotel building. So basically you're looking at cost of buildings and machineries used in manufacture. So basically whenever we're talking of deductions granted on cost of machineries and buildings used in manufacture, what should come at the back of our mind is what? Is investment deduction. So talk of capital deductions granted on cost of buildings and manufacture and machineries used in manufacture. So you'll find that the main aim of this is the main aim of investment deduction. You'll find that also another key element you can also note and say, investment deduction is deducted in the income tax computation. ID is deducted on the income tax computation. Or in arriving at the taxable income. That is very key concept that you must always have in mind. And that's why we talked of capital allowances. Because if you can recall on the previous videos when we were looking at the approaches in determining the taxable income, we mentioned capital allowance is very key as an allowable expense. So this is a very simple and clear definition of what ID is. Then the next question will be, person will ask, Mwalimu, what are the costs qualifying for ID? So that should take us to costs qualifying for ID. So looking at this cost qualifying for ID, my good students, this is what you are going to do. We are going to start with number one, understanding the items that will qualify for what? Understanding the items that will qualify for ID. You can have this note. Number one, we normally talk of what? Cost of factory building. That is number one. Cost of factory building. That's a cost that will qualify for ID. Number two, we normally talk of cost of machines used for purpose of manufacture. Cost of machines used for purposes of manufacture, e.g., we normally talk of processing machines. Number two, we normally talk of weighing machines. Number three, we normally talk of packaging machines. Number three, we normally talk of what? Conveyor belts. Also, is that part of that? Conveyor belts. Conveyor belts. ETC. So long as this item, so long as this machinery is used, what? Is used in manufacture. Then, number three, what will we be talking about? We'll be talking of cost incidental, and mark it very well. Mark this very well. We are talking of costs incidental to the acquisition of a machine. Cost incidental to the acquisition of machine. So we normally talk of incidental cost, right? Incidental cost. And ideally, whenever you're talking of incidental costs, what should ring at the back of our mind? Anytime you are talking of incidental costs, my good students, what should you know? For incidental costs, this is what we are talking about. For incidental costs, this is what we are talking about. Assuming that I purchased machinery, this is processing machinery, processing machine. Assuming the cost of processing machine is, say, 1 million. In this case, I need to transport this machine to our premises. So transportation costs, right? Assuming 200,000. Talk of what? Installation cost. Talk of installation cost. Talk of installation cost. Assuming maybe 500,000. So my good students, these two costs that we are incurring before probably we've utilized the machine, these are what you're terming them as incidental costs. These are what you're terming them as incidental costs. And that means that these costs, we are going to capitalize them in our cost of machine. You're going to capitalize these costs. So that in the event that I was to determine the qualifying cost, because by now I know we had already talked about what? Qualifying cost. So if we'll be talking of qualifying cost, our qualifying cost would be how much? Would be 1,700,000. So these costs are what you're terming them as what? Incidental cost. So also those ones will qualify for what? Will qualify for ID. Will qualify for ID. Will qualify for ID. Now. That should take us to number four. Cost of workshop machines. Cost of workshop machines used to repair industrial machines. Cost of workshop machines used to repair industrial machines. Cost of workshop machines used to repair industrial machines. That one is also very key. Then after we've talked of that number, I want us to talk of number five. And this is an area that you must also be very keen. So number five, we normally talk of what? Cost of machines. Mark it very well, you're saying cost of machines used for purposes which are auxiliary to manufacture. Mark it well, you're saying cost of machines used for purposes which are auxiliary to manufacture. Which are auxiliary to manufacture. Which are auxiliary to manufacture. Whenever you're talking of these costs, what are we talking about? Example. Assuming that we are in a manufacturing company, and by bad luck, probably we have probably blackout. What will be the alternative? Of course, you're going to use what? You're going to use generators, correct? In the event probably that maybe I don't have enough water within our manufacturing area. Of course, I can either use water pump to pump our water probably from underground, or we can use what? You can use boreholes. So these are what you're terming them as auxiliary, meaning that they are kind of alternative. They are kind of the alternative. So examples of these auxiliary machines that we're talking about, we'll be talking of generators. We'll be talking of water pumps. We'll be talking of boreholes. We can talk of sewage systems. ETC. These are what you are terming them as what? Auxiliary to manufacture cost. So after we've talked of that, my good students, that should take us to number what? That should take us to number five. And number five, this is what we'll be looking at. Of course, the other number, ideally we'll be talking of civil works. example of these civil works that you're talking about. So kindly allow me to raise here. Allow me to raise here. Talk of civil works. And the civil works that you're talking about here, this is what? Maybe we'll be talking of what? Parking bays. Talk of what? Parking bays. Talk of parking bays. We can talk of parking bays. We can talk of perimeter walls or security walls. Security walls or perimeter walls. So basically, that is, those are some of the main elements that you must always be having at the back of our mind when we are looking at what? Qualifying items for ID. When you are looking at qualifying items for ID. When you are looking at qualifying items for ID. When you are looking at qualifying items for ID. Now, the juicy part of this concept is now on the rates. The juicy part of this concept is now on the rates. Is now on the rates. I want us to talk about the rates for ID. I want us to talk about the rates for ID. And as I had mentioned, remember, this is where we have amendments. This is where we have amendments. We are going to compare what we had in before 2020 and what is the current rate that we should be using right now. So looking at ID, talk of rates for ID. This is very important. Rates for ID. Rates for ID. Rates for investment deduction. And this is what you are going to be tested for those students who will be doing their examinations in 2021. We'll be using the current rates, of course. So looking at these rates for ID, we can look at it in this manner. So we have 2020. And of course, this is the one that you're going to be tested, unless examiner had mentioned that this asset, because most of the time out, they normally test the previous financial year. And in 2021, when you'll be talking about the previous financial year, that should be 2020. So that is the last financial year that we'll be talking about, 2020. So in 2020, these were the amendments that were done. Actually, not amended, but it's now an act. So in 2020, if I'm dealing with rates for ID, I'll be talking of 50% for the first year. 50%, this is first year. This is first year. 50%, that will be first year. What about subsequent years? Subsequent years, we'll be talking of what? We'll be talking of 25% on reducing balance, on reducing balance, on reducing balance, on reducing balance. Because if you can compare, like before 2020, that is a 2019 backwards, that is a 2019 backwards, 2019 backwards, you noted that the rate for ID was at the rate of what? 100%, was at the rate of 100%. But the amendment that were done in this case, we'll be saying that ID, first of all, for the first year, I'm going to grant all these items at the rate of 50%. Then the subsequent years, I'll be granting them at the rate of 25% on reducing balance, on reducing balance. Now, understand this concept clearly. Assuming that you are talking of factory building, assuming that you are talking of what? Factory building. And I want to provide investment deduction on this factory building. How are we going to handle that? So if I'm talking of the factory building here, if you're talking of the factory building here, maybe the cost of this factory building, say, is 1 million, correct? The cost of the factory building is 1 million. And I want to provide ID using the current rates. How are we going to handle that? How are we going to handle that? So we are going to say, in providing our ID, of course, I'll be talking, that should be our first year. Our first year will be 1 million times 50%. That should give us a figure of 500,000. So this will be my ID for the first year. This will be our ID for the first year. That should be our ID for the first year. What about the second year? The second year now, I'll be talking of what? 500,000, the balance times what? 25%, which in that case, that should give us how much? Let me pick my calculator right now. So in that case, we'll be talking of what? We'll be talking of 25% times 500,000, I should be having a figure of how much? 125,000. That will be our ID for the second year. What about the third year? Now the third year, because you're talking of reducing balance, I should be talking of 500,000, we deduct 125,000. So 500,000, we deduct 125, I should be talking of how much? 375,000, we multiply by 25%. So that should give us times 0.25, I should be talking of 93,750. So the concept will just repeat itself all through. This is what you're terming it as what? Reducing balance. This is what how we're terming it as reducing balance. You'll find that this is one of the change that was done. And if you're not keen enough, suppose you're using last semester's notes, you'll find that you'll not get these ones, my good students. And that's why I want to encourage you guys to join MDARASA classes. We have two packages. We have the virtual live class. These are the classes which are conducted as per the set timetable that we have. And the beauty part of it is that in the event that you missed a class, you can still access the recorded version of that class. The second package is we have the pre-recorded classes. These are the classes which are recorded from topic one to the last topic, meaning that you can study anytime. You can watch these videos anytime, even without internet, because the videos are downloadable for you to watch them offline. And then also on that package, you're going to get what? You're going to get class notes, of course, updated class notes. You're going to get revision question and answers. Actually, what more do you need to pass your exams? So this is what MDARASA has provided for you guys. So if you've not joined MDARASA classes, kindly, you can always contact us on 07-08-068-851 for any inquiry or for any guidance on how you can join our classes. So remember, this is only one part that we've done in relation to the changes that were done in tax. We also have changes in IBD. We also have changes in WTA and so many changes that were done in relation to what? In relation to these rates. Some will argue that you are going to be provided in the papers, but remember, you will not be provided all the rates because there are some rates that you must always have at the back of your mind. So, in such an event, you'll find that we'll be looking at all these updated elements which were done in tax and also looking at ID. There's also a very important concept which you normally term it as what? Which you normally term it as the 10% test. And this 10% test, I'll want us to do it in our next class. Thank you so much, guys. Share this video. Inform your colleagues and friends that rates have changed in tax, so they should update their notes. Thank you so much, and let us meet in the next session. Thank you.